If you're a home watchmaker, being able to replace a broken jewel is critical if you're going to be dealing with vintage watches. So if you're a new watchmaker or even a more experienced one, then you're probably looking at buying the Chinese clone of the Horia tool versus buying a vintage Seitz jewel press. Well, I can tell you, after 30 years of repairing and restoring vintage watches, there's absolutely no question why the Seitz press is a better choice, and I'm going to show you why. So let's look at the difference between the two. The Horia style jeweling tool is designed to push friction fit jewels in and out by turning the micrometer on the top of the tool, and it does a pretty good job at doing that. Granted, the pusher pin that centers the jewel has a lot of slop, so you have to make sure that the edges of the pusher are not hitting the sides of the plate hole, which could damage it. These clones are most often bought as a compromise because most home watchmakers have a hard time justifying Horia's almost $2,000 price tag for a full set with the press and the basic pushers and anvils compared to buying the clone version, which comes in around $150 to $300. Now, on the other hand, the Seitz jewel press will not only press in friction jewels, but it can be used for many other types of repair work. One of the criticisms against the Seitz jeweling tool that I read is that people say it's harder to press in jewels with the lever, as opposed to the Horia tool, where you just turn the micrometer. This is most often caused by people just repeating what they hear, because anyone who's familiar with the Seitz tool knows that it comes with an accessory that replaces the lever so that you can turn the micrometer by hand if you're just adjusting side shake. Now, in addition to that, the Horia tool micrometer is divided into 50 increments, each equaling 1/200 of a millimeter, while the Seitz micrometer has 100 increments equaling 1/100 of a millimeter. And this makes it much easier to do small adjustments on end shape when you're working with jewels around the escapement, where the end shape is much smaller than, say, a wheel like the center wheel. Now, a minute ago, I mentioned that you had to be careful to make sure that the pusher is centered on the jewel, so you're not pressing on the edge of the plate hole. If you run across a jewel that has damage around it, the Seitz jeweling tool also comes with broaches, which can be used to clean up the edges of damaged plate holes before a new jewel is pressed in. One, ensuring that it's perfectly sized for the new jewel and that there's no deviations around the edge of the hole which could cause the jewel to break. Not only can these broaches be used for cleaning up holes, but you can also use it to enlarge a jewel hole in the plate when you run into a situation where the available stock jewel width does not have the pivot hole size that you need. Now, in all fairness, the Horia does have brooches available at around an additional $300 US, but with the Seitz tool, they just come standard and you can still buy new ones today. But here's where the Seitz tool really starts to shine. Probably one of the most valuable uses I've found of the Seitz jeweler is being able to re-jewel a jewel setting that's in a chaton. Many vintage watches, including the Hamilton 4992B that I worked on in my last video, have the jewels encapsulated in the chaton, which is then pressed into the jewel hole in the plate or bridge. These type of jewel settings used in vintage watches are becoming harder and harder to find. So certainly having the ability to either re-jewel an existing setting or even to make a new setting altogether is sometimes the difference and whether or not you'll even be able to repair the watch. Now, if that isn't enough reason to use a Seitz press, let's say you're working on a movement that has a unjeweled pivot hole or arbor hole. And let's say it's become out of round or even egg shaped due to excessive wear from the pivot. You can't close that type of damage with a staking set. That requires a repair called uprighting. With the use of a centering pin and then indexing that pin to a good jewel hole, the damaged hole in the plater bridge can be burnished so that it's slightly larger while remaining centered on its opposite jewel, which now allows you to either install a bushing, a larger jewel setting, or even a friction fit jewel. And here's the thing, guys. I have only scratched the surface on the repairs that can be made with this tool. So if you're thinking of purchasing a jeweling tool, consider first what type of movements you're planning on working on. As you can see, not only is the Seitz jeweling tool perfect for not only modern friction fit jewels, but it gives you the ability to repair things that the majority of home watchmakers don't even realize. So if you want to learn about all the repair techniques that can be done on the Seitz jeweling tool, I'll be covering all these repairs in detail in Lesson 9 of my watchmaking course. So see the link in the description for more information. I also want to take a minute to thank all my Patreon supporters for your continued support. They are really the ones who have made these videos as well as this very channel possible from the very beginning when I started about a year and a half ago. So thank you all, and I'll see you in the next video.